I am become death, the destroyer of worlds.
In 1945, the USA created the first weapon of mass destruction. By dropping the atomic bomb on Hiroshima, they effectively ended the war in the Pacific. After the end of World War II, the world was split into two, East and West, and this marked the beginning of the era called the Cold War.
When you hear the air attack warning, you and your family must take cover.
The Manhattan Project was the start of the nuclear arms race. With Robert Oppenheimer working on the world's first atomic bomb in America, it was only a matter of time before Russia would have its own. From 1947, the US and the USSR started to build up their arsenals to compete with each other, and so the theory of nuclear deterrence was born. So what is nuclear deterrence theory?
Put simply, nuclear deterrence is the idea of using nukes to keep nukes in check. If one side launches nuclear weapons, the other is sure to launch theirs in retaliation, which makes launching an act of suicide. In the end, neither side can use its nukes. It's thanks to this doctrine that the world's two superpowers have avoided all-out confrontation.
Pretty simple, right? So, surely this theory should work. Well, like all things, it has its pros and its cons. Let's start with the pros of nuclear deterrence theory. So what key things are required for this theory to work?
First, you must have nuclear weapons. Second, you must never use them first. And third, and most important, if someone attacks you, you must strike back.
From 1947 to 1991, the US and USSR built up their nuclear weapon stockpile. After a while, it became clear to both sides that they had enough destructive capability to effectively wipe each other out several times over. As a result of this, the doctrine of MAD, or mutually assured destruction, came about during the mid-60s. This belief was based on the size of a country's arsenal and their unwillingness to wipe out civilization. MAD guaranteed the world's safety and halted the US and USSR from deploying their nuclear weapons and effectively ending all life.
Does nuclear deterrence work? Yes. In the meantime, while we strive for full disarmament, and obviously that's clearly not going to happen anytime soon because humans are way too stubborn to get rid of the technology, we have deterrence in place.
But the theory of nuclear deterrence exists only on paper. In reality, there's no guarantee that either side would follow through with retaliation. Let me give you a real-world example. Let's say country X launches first against country Y. If the people in charge of country Y are like you and me, they're not going to be able to retaliate, knowing that they're effectively ending all human life.
So then the weak link in nuclear deterrence theory is the uncertainty of retaliation.
Bingo. And that creates a loophole country X can exploit to launch the first strike.
In a sane, rational world, it makes sense to abolish nuclear weapons, as who wants to see the end of the world, right? Wrong. For all those countries that concede that a nuclear war would be the biggest mistake mankind could inflict upon itself, there are those individuals who believe that they have the upper hand by having nuclear weapons. Many countries that historically did not have nuclear capability now possess the technology, such as North Korea, Iran, and Iraq. These countries now use the threat of atomic weapons to intimidate those countries that have abandoned the nuclear arms race. Another factor we can take into consideration is terrorists gaining access to these types of weapons and effectively making MAD redundant. Individual groups, rather than countries, can now gain access to weapons of mass destruction, leaving the doctrine of the Cold War obsolete. We can also take into consideration the fact of human pride. No one wants to be known for ending civilization and being the destroyer of the world. Cases of human pride are all part of history. For example, during the Cuban Missile Crisis, the commander of a Russian submarine refused an order to launch a nuclear armed torpedo at an American destroyer. In retrospect, he was a hero, but this was a key piece of evidence showing that the theory did not work.
Nuclear deterrence has worked so far. And the argument that if we don't have nuclear weapons, that we are more vulnerable to nuclear attack, or indeed conventional attack, is unproven. I think from the point of view of somebody who fundamentally hates war and strives for peace, I think the very existence of nuclear weapons is too dangerous to contemplate. And therefore, personally, I think that all nuclear weapons should be decommissioned.
During the height of the Cold War, the number of nukes shot up dramatically from 13 in 1947 to 64,099 in 1986. Since the end of the Cold War, the number of nuclear weapons has gone down drastically, but some are still used today. In the UK alone, we spend around £2 to £2.4 billion on Trident. And in the US, they spend on average £20 billion a year on their nuclear stockpile.